part of your curriculum. The sessions we had in the past, I don't think can be easily repeated because they were a part of a particular mindset, a particular time set, a particular era. So I think the ones you've saved, the kind of Q&A we had with students and the manner in which you conducted it, it's part of your academic curriculum. Use it and then ask them to debate it. Because I don't think such things can be easily repeated, Dr. Ramachandran. So therefore, I urge you, it's not for self-issue, but I think it's an education class by itself. I want to also congratulate and give my prayer and blessings to your new batch who are starting a whole new life in the academic session, which is going to take them towards the next level of living and life, because they're coming out of school and suddenly it's starry-eyed. Now they're going to college. And then also they're coming to a business school and they're going to come into management, which means all of them are going into the market. They're all going to go into the market in different aspects of management. So I want to convey my deepest good wishes, blessings as a mother to each one of them. May they succeed in life. And not only do they live their life, they lead their life all along because these are leadership schools. What you're going to groom them is leadership in management, leadership in business, and leadership in all creative ways of living. The way things are changing now at post-COVID times. So here is my welcome, prayer, blessings, and best of all the possible good wishes I can give as a mother prayer that they succeed and get the maximum out of the manner in which you will groom them. And I know with post-COVID times, you must have also tweaked your courses in such a way that they become each class, each content, each lecture, is relevant to post-COVID times, COVID and post-COVID times, because COVID is not going to go away. The kind of changes COVID has brought in are almost permanent for a long time to go. I'm not talking about masking. I'm not talking about social distancing. I'm talking for value for health. I think that is the biggest message which every student I would like to begin with. I would have never begun like that when I met you physically. I would have never started with health. We were taking health for granted. Now I would not take it for granted. If I were to open a school and the way you are asking me, my biggest message to every student who's attending this class today, which is the virtual inauguration, is first is value for health. If you have got health, you got books, you got college, you got learning, you got everything, and you got wealth. But if you have no health, there is no wealth. And wealth is not in financial terms. Wealth is richness of life. Richness of life cannot come without health. So my first message to my youngsters, please convey this even physically when you connect them, other than virtually, is how do you value health? Why should you value health? I think it's now, you and I don't, as teachers, need to explain why is health more important. If you don't have health, you are dependent. You are dependent on everybody else for help. You are helpless. You need oxygen to breathe. Look, we got clean oxygen free, and here we have to spend thousands and thousands to get some oxygen back in the in the ICUs. So let's value the open air, clean air, which we have free. We took it for granted all the time. So A, never go into polluted areas. I would urge them. You get invited for weddings. You get invited for festivals. You get invited to large halls of air conditioned. You shall not go without a mask anymore. For a long time. So even sitting in classrooms, they will protect themselves. But now that the festival season is coming, they will birthday parties, not to oblige, they will learn to say no for the benefit of their health. That means if you, like for instance, not more than keeping social distances, a attend the greetings, attend the festivals. So my first message to my young children, my daughters and sons who are in your classroom today, is health. Learning health. That means you will need to have classes on health management. Dr. Ramachandran, you must begin. What is health? What is managed? And health is not just physical. Health is emotional. Health is spiritual. It's mental health. It's physical health. Intellectual health. When I say intellectual health, it means intellectual morality. It's healthy. It's health. Healthy. It's clean. It's pure intellect. It's clean emotions. See, healthy, we limit ourselves to physical. In my mind, it's no more physical. It's emotional health. It's spiritual health. It's intellectual health. Because you're not studying management to cheat. You're learning to do ethical business. That's called intellectual integrity. To me, integrity and health are two sides of the same coin. So if this education gives them this kind of larger integrity, now let's go to the IQ. So I would start with health quotient. Health quotient, then I would come to three levels for students, which I believe are very important. Intelligence quotient is, now your academics is going to give them a lot of information, a lot of knowledge. To me, that is intelligence, IQ. A lot of written. So my first message now would be, while you virtually educate them, you will now not teach them. You will make them creative and make them learn and be hungry for a project, self-learning. So now it's not feeding. It's not feeding. It's researching. It's self-teaching. It's self-learning. And it's more of discussions. So evaluate them on the quality of the research they've done. Look, the manner in which internet learning has now assumed proportions and value in the last less than now 8 months, I think makes them all teachers. So as GRD is concerned, GRD shows them, these are your references. These are your podcasts. These are your YouTubes. So if we can research them on, go into print, visual listening material, that to me is really making them masters. So now you are making them learners and masters of their own subject. And then ask them to take the class virtually. How do they take the class? And evaluate them, how do they take a class? That means you are improving their communication skills and in confidence as a bonus. So today's times is a lot of creativity. Now it's not jobs looking for jobs. It's looking for self-employment. Because you see, the second casualty of COVID has been jobs. Jobs, because the first thing you do is cut the costs in every way you can. But if you're self-employed, will you cut a cost on yourself? No, you'll cut others, but you'll not cut yourself, which means that if you are moving towards this kind of learning, is make them self-reliant. Education, which makes them self-reliant. In a crisis, I can earn, I can generate, I can be of help, I can be creative. And my needs are, that comes from the next quotient I will move to, is emotional quotient. So if your emotions and your needs and your inner greeds and your material dependence is low and your emotions are well channelized, you will take the crisis as it comes. So from health quotient, I would bring them to intelligence quotient, which is research orientation. Then comes emotional quotient, which is their emotions management. Now you are dealing with very many youngsters. You and I have gone through the age. We've all learned by committing mistakes. So as a mother, I would always urge my child, look, learn from my mistakes. I would say learn, but they wouldn't. They'd say, no, you made mistakes. Please allow us to make mistakes. But some mistakes are very, very heavy. They are very costly. So which means when you have emotions in management, you are making better choices and you're making careful choices. You still make mistakes. So I want them to, on emotional quotient, to develop, because studies alone may not make you emotionally masters, because that is your own derivations of the education, what you derive out of the intellectual learning. And for emotional quotient, I want to give these few high points for the students. I would say, if you plant honesty, children, you will earn trust. So that means you want learning, you want trust, you will plant every day an emotional quotient or a quotient of honesty. Number two, you want friends. You want friends, or you want friends. All of us want friends. You will reap friends if you plant goodness every day. So honesty, goodness. You want to be great. You want to be great, then plant your humility every day. So humility, you will reap greatness. Perseverance, you will reap victory. Considerations, you will reap harmony. Hard work, you will reach success. Forgiveness, you will reap conciliation. Openness, you will reap intimacy. Openness is intimacy. Patience, you will reap improvements. Faith, you will reap miracles. So if you can work on these sowing and reaping, which is sowing honesty, reaping trust, sowing goodness, reaping friends, sowing humility, you will reap greatness, sowing perseverance, reaping history. I've given you a whole list. If you can plant these seeds, you will get them. You don't plant them, then all right, I will give you the other side. You plant dishonesty, you'll get distrust. You plant selfishness, you will reap loneliness. You plant pride every day, you will reap destruction. You plant envy, you will reap trouble. You plant laziness, you will reap stagnation. You plant bitterness, you will reap isolation. You plant greed, you will reap enemies. You plant worries every day, you will lots of wrinkles. You will reap lots of wrinkles because you are worrying, you've got lots of wrinkles. You plant sin, you will reap guilt. You will reap guilt. So you want to be guilt-free? Stay away from sin. So friends, this is the emotional quotient, which education, the intent, the books, the research, but you got to get derivatives out of it. Now I want to give you a little personal experience before I go to the last quotient, which is, I was a student of political thought. In my master's, political science, political thought was my favorite subject besides international law, etc. And in the political thought, I was reading Plato, Socrates, Aristotle, Machiavelli, Chanakya, all political thought. Locke, Rousseau. So all these I was reading. And at that time, I didn't have the luxury of Wikipedia. I didn't have the luxury of the Googles of the day. We didn't have the podcasts and YouTubes and research. And when we didn't have that, what did I have? I had the whole library, the hard book, the hardware. So, and I was a traveler. I was a tennis player. I had to travel. But I loved the subject. And I wanted to be also topper in my class because I didn't want to be known, oh, she only knows plays tennis. She's only a tennis player. No, I wanted to know for myself, I'm a tennis player, but also a very caring student. I love being studied. So I used to carry a lot of books in my suitcase while I used to travel for my tennis days. There was a smaller book of clothes and bigger book, a bigger suitcase of books. And what were those books? Nothing but research. If I was studying Plato, I would pick up every book of that Plato in that library. And the librarian was a dear friend. Instead of allowing only two books, she would allow me six books. She would make that concession for me. She was very happy somebody was reading and using a library. So I would carry all the six books on Plato. And guess what I was reading? I was reading the growth of this man. I was trying to see how did this man grow to be a Plato? What kind of parenting did he have? What kind of environment did he have? Why did he think the way he did? I was on the why. I forgot the factor that I had to take an exam. I forgot the factor that there are important questions in this. But guess what? Because of that all-rounded reading I did, I was a master on Plato. I could write a whole thesis on Plato. And when the exam came, I didn't have to revise anything because I was a master of my subject when I did it. And sure enough, it made me took me to the top of my class. It took me top of the class despite missing. So when I went to say, thank you, Dr. Ramachandran, then it was Dr. J.C. Anand saying, thank you, Dr. Saab, you made me achieve the class. She said, no, you've been your own teacher. Don't pass on the credit to me. Now, you won't have to pass the credit to Dr. Ramachandran when you top the class. Dr. Ramachandran will say the same thing to you, what Dr. Anand told me. No, you've done well because you were your own teacher. I only guided you. Which books are the good books to read? So Dr. Ramachandran and the GRD, they're to guide you. But you're the one who has to master this art of research and learning. And emotional quotient comes out of these books. The growth of the person and the subject gives you the essence of it, the extraction of application to life. And the last quotient, which I would urge you to keep in mind, it's not too early to read the Gita. It's not late at, early to read the Upanishads and the Vedas. It's not too early to go into these programs of Art of Living or the Isha Foundations and the other programs. Get into a spiritual group too, a spiritual sangat, a spiritual samagam. That will build values. It will make you a better Hindu or a Muslim or a Christian or a better human being. Most important is it will make you a very good human being. Without spiritual quotient, you cannot have the human quotient, the humanity quotient. So I would say, if I would do a wrap up and the inaugural for your class with all my prayers and blessings, is health quotient, intelligence quotient, emotional quotient, and the HQ, which is spiritual quotient, which is called the humanity quotient. If you keep these in mind, as you study your books, as you research, and as you virtually learn, and when you get an opportunity to go. And today, intelligence quotient, you can't do without, means the IT quotient. IT quotient, you just cannot do without it. But the IT quotient is interlinked with your intelligence quotient, because when you are going to study, you will have to use the IT tools completely to pick up knowledge. So with this, these remarks, I do hope these little cues I gave you, you will. It's very interesting. You know what, Dr. Ramachandran, I'm seeing one student who's sleeping on his pillow and watching me. Can you beat it? That's the luxury of the class today, the virtual class, that you can afford to even have your head on the pillow and listen. But you can't do that if you were in a physical classroom. You would have said, hey, get up, stand up, have a glass of water, have a little walk around and come back. You won't do that now. But I saw one young boy with a head on his pillow watching me. But I think he just disappeared now. He's disappeared. So with this, I offer my blessings and certainly miss coming to Coimbatore for this kind of physical inauguration. Hey, the boy straightened up. He straightened up. He disappeared again. But anyway, I thought this would be good enough to bring you to the inaugural. Look after your life. As I said, you will not only live your lives, you will now lead your lives. Lead in the manner as situation demands. And that, Balaji, were you having your head on your pillow? No, it was another one. Okay, it was another person. Anyway, thank you so much. It's been wonderful. This guy. That guy's disappeared again. I'll tell you the name. Ramu, when he comes to your class, you can bring him. But that's the luxury of the virtual class today. But thank you so much and wish your GRD the very best. By the way, thank you for giving me Isha Arora, one of your best students who's with me now. She's suffering me for last 2.5 years plus. Isha can be asked. She's suffering me, but I'm not suffering her. I'm gaining huge amount of creativity from her. She's your product and she's part of Team Raj Nivas. And she's put social media of Raj Nivas right at the top because of her entire creative work. She's also added so much of creativity to a new site we launched called Demonstrative Learning. So thank you for giving me a student on demand. But then she's chosen to stay back at Raj Nivas and be a very integral part of a team called Team Raj Nivas, which you fortunately visited, Raj Nivas. I do hope you bring your students one day and you yourself to Raj Nivas before I call it a day as Lieutenant Governor Puducherry. I complete 5 years next year. That's my longest tenure in life ever done in any posting. Thank you and bless you and wish you the very best. God bless. Thank you. and inaugurate. Congratulations on your first day of your course and your batch starting today at the DRD. Thank you.
What a blessing that all these students who are coming into college to probably have you to probably bless them. Thank you so much. I've got one question to ask you, rather, because it's always Q&A when it happens with Dr. Kiran Bedi, and the best of the answers we could get from anybody is none other than you. The question that I've got is, when you, there is only one question. When you went into college, what was your first day thoughts? How exactly, what exactly you were thinking that point of time?
I was, you'd be surprised to know, I listed out all activities which are available in college. And I've booked myself for all. Whether it's declamations, whether it's NCC, whether it's tennis, dramatic society, I found the time for everything. Other than the samosa in the canteen.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Can I have the host to probably do the vote of thanks?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Mom, it is a blessing for all of us to be listening to your words and witnessing your presence as many young minds today are stepping into a new phase in their lives. We express our heartfelt gratitude for gracing us with your time and presence as these blooming faces kickstart their new path in their lives. Thank you so much, Mom.
Thank you, Meenakshi. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, madam, for your time. And
thank you, and all the very best. See you soon as possible, as yes. God so desires. Take care of your health. Remain healthy, fighting fit, mind, body, soul. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mom. Now over to my co-host and MC, Meenakshi.
Thank you, Meenakshi. Getting back to our alumni, we welcome the amazing Akshaya Viji. Akshaya Judd Stephen is working as a financial analyst.